Here. Hoping that you are all good and you are ready with the chapter number one of English grammar. And chapter number one is introduction. Yesterday we talked about the word grammar. You have all the time in your hands at this time of lockup. Make optimum use of the time you have and try to enhance your writing and grammatical skill. Let me introduce you to the chapter number one, and that is Introduction to the Grammar. As we know, any language helps us to communicate our ideas, what we want to talk about, our opinions, what is right and what is wrong, and needs the way the wish we like to them express. You express anything in a different manner, I express in a different manner, I use my tools and you can use your tools too. It acts as a tool. Tool, do you know what is the meaning of a tool? Tool is a mechanism. It can be anybody's mechanism which help us to speak, think or write. Any language, as you know that it has two parts. Language can be divided into maukhik, jisko aap bolte, verbal and written. If you want to enhance both your verbal and written skills, you must know about the certain facts about this language. Like any other language, English language too must be learned in its two forms, namely the spoken or the phonetic aspects and the written or script form. What do you understand by the term phonetic? If you pronounce a, Hindi mein a ke saath kya sound aa raha hai? A. Then that is phonetic sound. The voice which comes from your vocal cord is known as phonetic sound. Letter or alphabets. English language has 26 alphabets and these are all we know, A to Z. We can write them in capital or small, and in any two forms we can write them simply like A, or we can use the cursive forms. These 26 alphabets are divided into 5 vowels and the other remaining are the consonants. You know what are vowels? A, E, I, O, U are 4 vowels and there are 21 consonants. The remaining alphabets of the Varnamala are known as consonants. Consonants are B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y and Z. Now on page number 3 there is an exercise. What you have to do is you have to insert the vowels. First is P-P-R. P-A-P-E-R. We are inserting A and E, and A and E are vowels. Like this you have to complete this whole exercise. Now we come to the second part. Second part is words and spelling. When we learned A to Z, then we will start writing the words or what we call spelling. For example, my name is Ritu. So it will be spelled as R-I-T-U. Every group of alphabets which have certain meanings are known as words or spellings. In simple words, word is a combination of letter arranged in a particular order to give a certain meaning. It means that it should have a meaning. It should make some sense. The way letters are arranged is known as spellings, and the way we arrange these letters, jaise maine aapko bataya, R-I-T-U. Ritu is a group of word which has certain meaning. Ritu means what? What? Ritu means what? Season. Season. So, if we write R-T-U-I, is it correct? No. When we write R-I-T-U, then it will be the correct spelling of my name, Ritu. And it is the most important part of the language. Every care should be exercised in it, as it may result into a wrong word or a non-word. If we don't know the spelling of a word, it can be a non-word or a wrong word. And now your second task will be take 3 words. Jaise yahan pe diya hua N, E and D. N, E, D. What you have to do is, you have to do at home. You have to make any 5 words using these 3 alphabets, N, E and D. Is that clear? Next. Next is alphabetical order and dictionary. What do you understand by the term order? order means incorrect sequence. Alphabetical order means arrangement of alphabets in a correct sequence. A comes before B, B comes before C, D comes after C. This is the sequence or the alphabetical order of an English language. In the English alphabets, letter occur in a certain order. हम ये तो नहीं कहते A, D, B, F, G, H. हम क्या बोलते हैं? Correct order क्या है English alphabets का? A, B, C, D, E, F, G and so on till Z. This is known as the alphabetical order. If I say कि write the names of your family members in a correct alphabetical order, then you have to do what? What you have to do? You have to just check whose name starts with A, B, then C, then E, F, G, H and so on. So, this will be the correct alphabetical order of all the family members. Any dictionary, and then we come to the part dictionary. Dictionary lists all its word in this order. You must be having dictionaries. Aap log bahut familiar hai dictionaries se. Dictionaries always start with the letter A. A, 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 B, A, C, A, D and so on. And it goes to Z. Z and Z. So that a reader can find words easily. Agar ye haphazardly likhi jayegi dictionary, toh will you be able to find it? Find the word you want to know? No. So it has to be written in an alphabetical order. If you want to look for the word school in a dictionary, agar aapko main ek word do, this word might be spelling. So, what you have to do, you have to go to that S and P. S ke baad P. So, the dictionary is always given in an alphabetical order. And your next task is, first task was you have to do the insert vowels. Then, you have to make three new words with the alphabets N, E and D. And your next homework or whatever assignment will be, you have to arrange the name of the months in an alphabetical order. If I ask you name the months of a year, you will start with January, February, March, April, May, June, July. That is not what I want. What I want is you have to arrange these names of the month in an alphabetical order. This is your second work, and I hope in the next class we'll be discussing. If you have any doubts, you can write those doubts on a paper, and I'll meet you on Saturday and we'll discuss about all the doubts in grammar or in introduction chapter. Tomorrow we'll be meeting for the second chapter, and that is the sentence. Please go through these two chapters very carefully, because we'll be discussing all our doubts on Saturday. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Have a nice day.